Hi, Hope Kids and Jam friends. Did you know that God put some scientific facts into the Bible thousands of years, even before they were discovered by human scientists? For example, in Isaiah 40:22, it says, "He sits enthroned above the circle of the earth." The Bible is saying that the earth is round, and we know that today too, but for thousands of years before, many people, even scientists, believed the earth was flat. Another example in the Bible says, "The earth hangs on nothing." Job 26:7 says, "He spreads out the northern skies over the empty space. He suspends the earth over nothing." But for thousands of years, many people believed the earth was sitting on top of something that held it up. Finally, the Bible says the universe has a beginning. Like in Genesis 1:1, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." But long ago, many people thought the universe had always existed and never had a beginning. God knows everything, even things people hadn't discovered yet. In fact, sometimes people have used the Bible to help them make new discoveries. That's what happened with Matthew Maury in today's story. Matthew Maury was a sailor who lived over 100 years ago. He was also an astronomer, naval officer, historian, oceanographer, meteorologist, cartographer, author, geologist, and an educator. He was nicknamed Pathfinders of the Seas. Most importantly, Matthew believed the Bible was completely true and loved reading it. He read and studied about Jesus and Peter like us. Matthew enjoyed reading the Bible and using science to study God's creations. He told many people that the Bible can help us understand science better because it was written by the omniscient God, the one who knows everything. Matthew's parents also believed in God, and his family moved to America to escape persecution. His father taught Matthew and his siblings the Bible, and they sang songs about God, they prayed, and Matthew even learned many verses by heart. Matthew's parents also taught him about the problem of sin and about God's son, Jesus. This helped Matthew make the most important discovery of his life, that he needed a savior to save him from his sin. Matthew became a sailor in the United States Navy when he was 19 years old. He wanted to learn all he could about the sea that God created. He knew God had created the seas and winds to do special jobs, so he studied currents and kept many notes. He planned on being a sailor his whole life, but then something terrible happened. He injured his leg, and Matthew's injury in an accident caused him to stop sailing. This was very sad for Matthew, but now he actually had time to study the notes he took from his time at sea. He kept thinking of Psalm chapter 8, verse 8. "The birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim in the paths of the sea." He wanted to find these paths in the seas. Matthew believed all the Bible is true, even the parts that talk about science and the way God made his world to work. Matthew trusted that God's word is true, and he chose to follow it. If he could find these paths in the sea, it would help many other sailors. It could even save lives because sailors would better know how to navigate and guide their ships. But how would he start? He studied logbooks kept by sea captains and made charts of the paths they mentioned, currents of the wind and ocean. Matthew also did something else to discover the paths in the seas. He took bottles and filled them with just enough weight so that they would float just below the surface of the water. He also put a note in each bottle telling whoever found it to write back to him and tell him where, when, and how they found the bottle. From the returned bottles, Matthew figured out where the bottle had traveled. He put these on his charts and over time discovered the ocean currents. He had found the paths in the sea God talked about in the Bible. People saved a lot of money and time by using Matthew's important discovery. His discoveries are still used today and have changed the way people sail across the ocean. Matthew trusted God's word even when people told him that he was silly to do so. God wants you to trust his word too. So the next time you study God's word, ask God to reveal the truth to you and how you can study and use God's truth and word to help you in your life and others.